Hello everyone, this is I'm Marianne, the Artsy Crafter. Welcome to my channel. Today we're going to do a fun little project with Bellyband in my new year journal called All About Me Journal. So today I just painted a few things to use. So this one here is I just painted a tree trunk and cut it out, and I put it on some cardstock first so it's quite sturdy, and then cut it out. One thing, I didn't measure it before I put it on the page, so I had to cut these things off because it didn't fit. And then this is the background image that I painted. I actually painted this one. And then I liked it so much I didn't want to use it on the background, so I decided to scan it into my printer and onto my computer, and then I printed out a copy, and I was quite pleased with it and mucked around with it, and I got it to the same, almost they look identical, so that I was happy with the coloring. So I did that, and I painted this little bird. This is a little bower bird, so this is a theme of today. Is the bowerbird is going to be collecting all these little trinkets, a little moon and a couple of keys, a couple of little leaves, and like a little coin thing. And this is what he's going to collect for his nest to attract his mate. And here in Australia it's summer, so he's a little bit late. We've had a cold season here so far, so he's been waiting for the warmer weather to come out and some sunshine, so he can build his little nest and attract his little mate. So I'm just going to cut that out, and we're going to put it on, find a page in the journal, and we can put that down, glue it on as a background. So I'll do that now. Try to get you in shot. And there we go. Put it on the page. This page mustn't be very square. Still that much there. Cut that off quickly. Happy this time it will fit. This time. So I'll just go and glue that on. It's a bit rusty, the pin. I told you before, I lost the cap off my glue, so I've been using a pin until I get another glue bottle. I think it's the only way I can get around that. Okay, put this down. With the background all done, and now with this one, I'm going to put this on here, and so I'll just glue these on here, and I can glue these little leaves onto the trunk on this side, and maybe one up here. Anyway, I will, before I do that, move this aside. So, as I said, where is my bowerbird? I haven't cut him out yet. Got another one here. This is the copy. I'll cut him out, and I'm going to put this on the page and make a little nest down here for him, and then instead of putting all these little trinkets in his nest, I'm going to hang them from the tree. How I'm going to do that, so I'll just have them hanging, dangling, something like this. And I want the moon up the top there, and we'll have them hanging. I have one up there, something like that. And so I was going to use those split pins to attach them, but then that makes up, they will be twisting the wrong way. So I decided I'm going to use a needle and some thick cotton and just sew them on the limbs. So I just have to, I'm just going to punch a hole in here. I might do it on the side here and get a hole in a piece of paper. Like that, except I want it on the other side so the cotton's behind, and I'll have it doubled up. I think might be better if I double it up, gives it a bit more strength. Then I'll just thread this moon through here. Oops, like that. And I'll just tie a knot. Like that. I'll cut the, I'll leave some dangly bits at the back here. Then I can get some tape. Might be a bit much. And tape this down. I'm going to need thinner tape. Cut this down a bit because it's a little bit wide. This is a wide tape. Turn it around. Might be easier. That, tape it to the back so that will keep it in place. Also, when you're sliding some tags or journal cards in there, it's not going to interfere with the knot at the back. And it would have been helpful if I actually covered the knot at the back, which I haven't. I didn't get quite there. And there we go, that's better. And I'll just trim off the bits that are sticking out the front. There's that bit that I was looking for. Take those little bits off. And there's got the moon, will hang down when I put it on the page. And I'll go ahead, you can see that here, it'll hang down and keep it in shot. I'll go ahead and do the rest of that, and I'll show you what it looks like when I come back. Okay, I'm back. I didn't end up using that one, I thought it was a bit too much. So this is how it looks, and I just glued on these leaves here, and now we can attach it to the page. Pick it up. This is what it looks like on the back. Just taped it all down so it doesn't move. And then you can just glue it top and bottom. And to do that, I'm going to use some fabric glue just to give it some extra strength. Whoops. A little bit too much coming out there. good if you could see it. There we go. Try and get in the center. Yeah, that's about it. Wind up to the top. Make sure my moon's facing the right way. Takes a minute for this glue to grab. Okay, now I went and, well, I was doing the other, I cut out the bowerbird. I was going to have him sitting in the tree, but I don't know. Will I do that now or have him, did have him down the bottom here? I'll put him aside for now because I wanted to create this little, his little nest down the bottom here. And I got all these little bits and pieces. You can see here, might bring that down. No, I can bring that camera down a little bit so you can see a bit better. There. Okay, so I had just little scraps of paper. And I just wanted to cover the tree trunk between those rocks, so I'm just putting bits and pieces, and I wanted some sparkly bits. This has got a little bit of sparkle on it, because like a lot of birds, the bowerbirds like to gather all the sparkly things, because you know, us females, we like our bit of sparkle, bit of bling. So I'm thinking about doing that, and then I'll just put this over the top here, so it looks a bit like a nest, and that's it all right there. And I think I might have him sitting about there on his nest. Okay, I'll put that aside and take these off. And I've got some tweezers here. Hold it down. I definitely have to get another one of these glue bottles because I cut the hole a bit too big, I think. It's just oozing out. Not to worry. Put that one in. And it just wants to stick to me more than it does to the page. We'll have to wait till that glue dries. Anyway, might use this, and so I'll put this here on his nest side here. Still wants to stick to my fingers. Keep you in shot. That. I got a little baby ant running around on my page. There we go. And hopefully they're starting to stick to the page now. Might add a bit more glue under this end. So there's my website, and then I went, and this is the journal card, and I went and backed it on some coffee dyed paper, yeah, which I must have stamped on at first, and then I coffee dyed over the top of it. I think I gessoed first and then stamped and then put copy dye over the top. And I'll just ink the edges like that. I'll do it in black. So that's that. And then the last thing that I want to put on there, if I can find, it's over this side here, is the sentiment. It says, observation is the greatest source of wisdom. So I'm going to put that on there. You'd either put it on there or on the back. Yeah. I think I'll put it on there. I mean, just maybe it covers up the leaves. Might do it in the middle or the side. Go on the side. So I'll do that. And then that should be finished, I think. Just a little fun little belly band. Just something different to what you usually see. There we go. We just have to slide it in there like that. Should let the glue dry first, just to show you that it will go in, I think. It was just caught on the side. There we go. Bring the moon over the front, because you usually see the owls sitting out at night time and he can sneak peek through the tree there. You can see him on the back tree. So that's it. We've got a bowerbird and an owl. So that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. And we'll be hopefully making some more, filling some more of these pages in as the month flies by. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye, everyone.